The Literary City with Ramjee Chandran, exclusively on indigomusic.com.
Hello again. I'm Ramjee Chandran, and welcome to the Literary City podcast on indigomusic.com. My guest today is the winner of the Booker Prize 2022, Shehan Karunatilaka, author of The Seven Moons of Maali, Almeida. To win the coveted Booker Prize is a great achievement, to say the least. But to write a murder mystery with the protagonist being in the afterlife is, in my book, real skill.
There is an old saying, dead men tell no tales. But how wonderful and useful it would be if we could follow a conversation into the afterlife. And what more wonderful than if you wrote about this idea and then won the Booker Prize for your efforts. Is this the stuff from which dreams are made? Clearly, if you consider my guest today, Shehan Karunatilaka, winner of the Booker Prize 2022. In Shehan's novel, The Seven Moons of Maali, Almeida, the main protagonist, Malinda Almeida, is dead, but his character lives on. The novel, set in a terrible patch of Sri Lankan history between, say, 1983 and 1990, is the story of a photojournalist who dies. And in the afterlife, he finds himself in the in-between, which is the state between down there, which is life on earth, and the light. And where the light is revealed at the end of the book. The protagonist is confronted by, of all things, a bureaucracy in the afterlife, and he is told that he has a week or seven moons to find out how he died if he was going to make it to the light. The novel touches the reader in many ways, not the least, to wonder what happens if we were indeed to find bureaucracy in the afterlife. Even the disappointment that visits us upon such a proposition is not rational, and yet. Shehan uses the second person as his literary tool.